I wanted people about your age to come together and have a chance you to meet him and come to recognize that disagreement does not automatically mean that we need to be disrespectful. I believe, and I've believed for a long time, it's possible to disagree without being disrespectful.
I talked with the students today about how learning how to verbally communicate is becoming a lost art in our society, our technical society. So that is also their greatest opportunity to advance as a leader, because they're able to develop the skills that the rest of the world is just saying, hey, that's not the world we live in anymore.
There's no replacement for face-to-face communication and interaction, and we call it community a lot. There's no replacement for that. No amount of digital connectivity can replace true community.
We live in a throwaway society. We live in a microwave society. Everything is right now. And that's true on the corporate level as well. I mean, companies that used to look at the long term, they're worried about their quarterly earnings over and over and over again. So it's kind of the society that we're in. But one of the most difficult things, I think, for young people is the understanding that you've got to invest the time, invest the effort, and the results come later.
We're all connected, and when you can see yourself in your leader, that makes them more human, that makes them more trustworthy. You know them better because you see them in you and you in them, and you're more willing to believe in them.
Opportunity to expose yourself to more perspectives, because you can't look at a situation just one direction. You have to look at it about multiple directions so you can answer any question that's thrown at you at that point.
Engage in leadership that we learned here is a responsibility, and it's not, nobody tells you, like, we want you, like, nobody pushes you towards leadership. You push yourself towards leadership, and you fill that position yourself because you feel like responsible for what's happening there. So I think I'm here because I wanted to fill leadership skills in my own community, which are lacking in more than one aspect.
Honestly, think a lack of courage is what derails them the most, because for a person to have a strong character, to stick by their principles, to stick by their values, to be true to who they are, it requires a lot of courage.
Oh, without courage, you're not going to stand up. You're not going to be able to walk alone. You're not going to be able to do what is right when no one is watching. It starts with courage, because that leads on to the aspect of competence. It leads on to commitment, to a core set of values, the conviction to stand. And I think all of that adds together. It starts with courage.
Well, never stop learning. I mean, always stretch yourself and learn as much as you can in the current environment that you're in, but also that prepares you for the future. You may not be the leader at your current job. You may not be the leader at your current place in school, but the more you serve, the more opportunities you will have to lead, because the greatest leaders our country has ever had in the public sector or the private sector were servants too.
Whenever I work with the people around me, the people that I consider to be in my community, whether that's my school or my family and my neighbors, I always try and talk to them as much as I can and try and create like a consistent flow of communication. That is number one for me when I'm working with other people, is knowing their concerns, what they think I'm doing right, what they think I'm doing wrong. And once I have the input of these people, I think that's the only time that I can make a wholehearted, something that I feel proud of, decision.
It's so complicated. I used to think that it was straightforward, just take charge, but there are so many layers that go into being a good leader, and that was pretty surprising to me.
Leadership to me is the ability to influence, lead, and motivate people to strive to be better, strive to do things that they wouldn't normally do.
I want to change society by making it better. I feel like currently now there's a lot of hostility and negativity, as you said, within our society. So I hope through education and actual communication between different groups will help us come to a clear understanding of how we're supposed to come together and be unified.
And I asked them, what's the opposite of success? And their answer was failure. And that's the world in which we live. You either succeed or you fail. But the reality is successful people fail at a much higher rate than unsuccessful people. They just never quit.
Doing anything great is hard, and it should be, because that's what makes it so special. And so sometimes being a great teammate and being a leader is helping facilitate other people's ability to be better.
My recommendation to you is to be on the lookout. Listen to others. You never know when those life lessons will be coming, and they may be coming from the least obvious places. Just listen for them.
For me, the definition of success has always been making a difference. And so it's not about how much money you make. It's not about how big your house is or what your car you drive, but it's about, did I make a difference in the lives of some people around me that I care about?
I wanted them to know, hey, you're going to fail. If you don't fail, you're not trying hard enough.
And it's a very engaged group of young men and women that ask very insightful questions, and they get it. And you can see when you're talking, you can see the wheels turning, and they understand, and they're connecting the dots.
A lot of things in society I would like to change, but the one major one that I think encompasses everything and would have the biggest impact on the world is to rid the world of apathy and complacency. Because I feel like a lot of the problems that we encounter have viable solutions out there, but the world as a whole is apathetic and complacent, and that we really don't care all that much no matter what we say.
One of the speakers, Colonel West, said live or dash, and I've always wanted to know what that meant. He was like, live or dash, when you die, what do you want to have on your headstone? When that dash is there, what does it mean to you? So that really hit me hard. What do I want to leave when I die? What will be my legacy? How will my leadership skills impact others? Will they remember me? Will I be forgotten?
The structure of the Constitution exists to preserve those principles. That's why we can judge whether the Constitution works by understanding these principles, by understanding the principles, our common vision, right? If you take it away, if you hang a cloth over it or something, you obscure it, you forget about it, if you can't see those principles, it's really, really hard, maybe impossible, to understand what the Constitution is for.
Among the words in that speech are these: a nation divided against itself cannot stand.
Leadership, I think, is the ability to take a diverse group of individuals and focus them upon the accomplishment and achievement of a singular goal.
And what I challenge people to be is a lifelong learner. You have to be willing to learn. You have to be willing to grow. You have to be willing to say, I'm wrong, I'm sorry. You have to be willing to grow to be a leader.
I've really gained a lot of knowledge through the really interesting speakers we've had. I mean, these older men and women have provided so much wisdom. I mean, just the things they're saying has just really inspired me. I'm not making this up. I'm really gonna go back and change the way I'm living my life. I've noticed that sometimes I don't put effort into things. You know, like even the way I talked about how I applied for this, it was kind of lazy. You know, I'm gonna go back and, you know, punch really hard into school and really change the way I've been looking at my life.
And so I think, like, if I was able to do this here, like in just like 3 days, many people could, the people there, back there, like in my region, could get along with others in many different countries. So I'm maybe excited to like become a leader for, like, there are many people who are in need, like especially in my region, like there are like many refugees who are, like, you think that you can do a lot when you grow up. And so like I'm excited to see if I really could do what I think I should do.
You know, it's so important to invest in these young people. We often think about them as being the leaders and the movers and shakers of tomorrow. The reality is they've got a lot of power today as well.
Life is about relationships. Life is about team. Life is about making a difference to other people. And I know a lot of times when we're younger, we're so focused on ourselves and what do I want to do and I have to work hard at this. It's hard to pull other people along. But some of the best things that you can do in life are pull people with you.
And you should seek out challenges. You should seek out opposing thoughts and perspectives in order to make yourself better.
You are going to be taking on the leadership responsibilities of the world at a very challenging time compared to history generally. Leadership is not nearly so much a privilege as it is a responsibility. And because you're gifted,
they're going to have a lot of responsibilities in the years ahead.
It's impossible to overstate the value of relationships. I really hope all of you will take the time and make the effort to come to know your peers in this group. You people are special people, and you're going to be special your whole lives.
right? I'm gonna write it says structure is one of the points.
You also have the counter-argument for the argument, so you can make the point even stronger.
There would be no crime. There would be nothing, right? Because everything would be known before it happened. But that is not a standard of living. That is not sustainable. That is not that is the exact opposite of what this country was made for.
It's also not possible.
Dig a little deeper. Why is it so bad for it to be stored? Why? I'm not coming at your argument, and I'm not saying it's wrong. I just want to
furthering
understand.
It? Yeah, no, I know exactly what you're saying.